It's been, I've had a rusty, when I've come out. I still feel a little bit like it's difficult to get into the swing of things, but I'm going to tell you about a driving trip in America, way out west, in which I met a butterfly who had this fantastic wingspan that was nearly 2 feet wide. She'd recently been injured, and she couldn't fly, so she asked me if she could bum a ride. In the shell of her old chrysalis, she carried her things. She tossed it in the back and stretched those beautiful wings. She sat there next to me with her front legs on the dashboard, those wings folded behind her, and her little head cocked forward. She told me her story. A price was on her head. This bastard entomologist pursued her live or dead. He vowed to hunt her down and to claim a large reward. He captured her and drugged her and he nailed her to a board. Her escape was narrow. She torn through her own wings. She saw my look of horror and she started to sing. Men and violins are intertwined. I go into a new man's land because men and violins are intertwined. Well, I see, I said, that not all men are violins. I'm not a violent man myself. She laughed and said, try not to get too attached to me, cause soon I will be well and I will fly away from thee. One afternoon when we stopped into a diner for a meal, she laughed and laughed about the plastic flowers on the table. We watched the birds and the tumbleweeds with fondness and with envy. I started seeing through her eyes the passing desert scenery. We came across some sad roadkill, a beautiful coyote. She sighed her butterfly sigh and once again sang softly. I'm going to a new man's land because men and violins are intertwined. One morning I came out of this Texaco station and I saw that she wasn't in the car anymore, so I figured she had run. But then I heard her high squeal. And I heard his low laughter. You'll never outrun me, he said. You are the girl I'm after. I chased down their voices to the side of the station. She was quartered between a wall and a soda machine. I moved as if by instinct. I did it without thought. I bring this tale, any compromise, to the ground on the roof. The butterfly was gone again when I turned around. But then her little song drew our attention to the sky. Though with a certain lack of grace, she had begun to fly. That was the last I saw of her. She never waved goodbye. She just flapped off and disappeared while singing with a sigh. I'm going to let no man's land be good, netted by a lonely song, intertwined. Thank you.